Dear students, I had already discussed about primary functions of a commercial bank. Now let us discuss about some other functions or secondary functions of a commercial bank. First one is agency and utility services. A bank provides various utility and agent banking facilities to its customers. Say for example, a bank provides a letter of credit to the exporter on behalf of the importer. Bank provides underwriting services to various businesses. Banks also provide facilities to its customer to pay their tax challans or premium of LIC or telephone bills, electricity bills and so on. Banks also provide a safe deposit vault on rent to its customers, which are also known as lockers, where the customers can safely store their precious jewelry or documents. Not only this, when some payments are to be made with foolproof security, that means when the instrument of payment needs to be very much reliable, so in that case bank provides services to the payer by issuing draft or pay order. Not only this, second function under other function is to provide various facilities with changing times. In present times, electronic transfer of money from the account of one customer to that of another customer of any other bank is done through facilities like NEFT and RTGS, which are possible because of core banking. Bank also provide safe deposit vaults and facilities of DMAT account, which is also known as dematerialized account, where shares, bonds and debentures can be held in electronic form. Now next one, that is scheduled banks. So first of all, what are scheduled banks? Banking companies which are listed in the second schedule of the RBI Act 1934 are called scheduled banks. That means those banks which are working as a bank and which are listed in this second schedule of RBI Act are called as scheduled banks. These banks which are established according to RBI Act 1934 are called scheduled banks. That means these are the banks which are established as per this RBI Act of 1934, and because they are established as per this RBI Act, therefore all rules and regulations of the Reserve Bank of India apply to these banks. Now let us have a look at a chart which describes about the scheduled banks which are working in India. What are the types of scheduled banks which are working in India? First one, that is commercial banks, and second one, that is cooperative banks. And under the commercial banks, again there are various subtypes, that are public sector commercial banks which are owned generally by government. Then there are private sector commercial banks which are owned by private individuals, institutions or a group of individuals. Then there are foreign banks which are actually established in foreign, but they are working or they are having their branches in India. And regional rural banks, these are generally working or they are established in the rural areas, and mainly they are established for providing credit facilities as well as banking facilities to the farmers or agricultures in the rural areas. Thank you, students.